It's Jann's birthday. Welcome, everyone. This celebratory time of us being together and running the store and booking gigs and knowing some of the most wonderful musicians on the planet, this sort of morphed into a gig slash combo party. So I'm elated to have everyone come and share this and share the music that we love and are all involved with for so many years. I'm going to hand it over to Jann because she's much more articulate than I, and she can tell you about what we have coming and what she has to say. And anyway, happy birthday, darling.
Thank you.
You can get the microphone now.
Happy birthday.
So for those of you who maybe have not been here before, their restroom is down these stairs all the way to the front of the store. So be, watch your step, because there are records to look at on the way, so it's kind of dangerous down there. And so it's a little more festive than usual, but let me also say that we tend to be a listening room, and as always, we have a special room for those people who want to have a conversation during the concert, including my husband, and that is behind the exit sign.
Spacious.
The spacious room behind the exit sign. I'm so grateful for all of you for being here, and the opportunity to stretch my brain at the Bop Shop. Aren't we lucky that we have this place to get together and experience awesome music and new music and new friends. So I hope everybody makes a new friend this evening in honor of my birthday. And in that same vein, there are a, pardon my French, boatload of cupcakes near the front door. Please have at least one, because if you don't, we'll all have to have more than one, which will be fine, but not in COVID. Speaking of COVID, one last thing. Out of respect for traveling and where we've all been and where we hope to go, if we would all please wear masks, I'll be putting mine on as soon as I shut up. So join us in masking again this evening, like we do here all the time at the Bop Shop at concerts. My dear friend Erik Lawrence has become such a treasured friend over the last few years. Tom says, Tom always talks about his friends, and I'm always like, yeah, right, yeah. But I've learned that he was not joking, especially when it comes to the gentleman behind me. So without further ado, let me introduce to you and join me in welcoming to Rochester the Erik Lawrence Trio.
Not to correct the birthday girl, but I was on the Bop Shop Records Facebook page, and it's the Harvey Sorgen Trio. Yeah.
I thought this was mine.
Yeah. We don't even know who you are.
I know.
No, it does. It says Harvey Sorgen.
Really?
Like Erik Lawrence.
It's been morphing like day to day. So.
Well, anyway, so Harvey Sorgen. You've seen him before, and you'll see him again. And you'll be happy for it.
Soon.
When is it? When are you playing here again?
I'm going to be here in November.
November.
With the Joe Fonda Quartet, with Jeff Lederer and Michael Rabinowitz and myself on tour. We're going to stop here at the lovely Bop Shop.
Yeah, why not?
All right.
Well, we'll have more introductions in a little bit, but this is a song that I wrote a while ago while I was roasting a turkey. It's called Boasting.
Thank you.
a trip around the world for everybody who's been staying home for so long. This is actually my first gig as a leader since, I don't know.
Since it said my name.
Oh, yeah. My last gig. I know, and I've been thinking for like 18 months, like, what am I going to say to an audience? Like, how did everybody like the Queen's Gambit? It was good, right? Awesome. Except you guys, you haven't watched it yet. It's good. So this was supposed to be so this all ties in a way. You know, they say jazz musicians, creative musicians, find connections when there aren't even any there. And but sometimes there are. For example, two years ago or so, Harvey and Michael Bizio, who was advertised to play with us here tonight, played here, and we had a wonderful concert where I think we might have outnumbered the audience, but there was a wonderful video recording of it, an audio recording of it, thanks to the good folks here. And then when I was supposed to do a gig in New Orleans after New Orleans Jazz Festival last year, at the Sidebar, which is where they do all the creative and interesting music, or where they did, because it's not there anymore. I had played there the year previous, and I was supposed to play there again for my birthday in April, right after the Jazz Festival, and right after playing there. And I didn't, because nobody did anything, right? And it was April of 2020. So what they did was we worked out an agreement with the wonderful Bop Shop Records, where we were able to use the video of our concert, and they broadcast our concert as part of the Sidebar Festival, which is the alternative, you know, creative jazz festival that happens at the same time as the Jazz Festival here in New Orleans. So, and that year that I did play there, I hung out with this guy, Matt Booth, who's a friend of mine, who lives in New Orleans. He's been down there for about 6 years. And when this weird thing happened where Michael Bizio couldn't make it all of a sudden, just a few days ago, right? And I said, well, you know what? In a year where I'm not doing any gigs at all, I happen to be playing this afternoon at a festival in Buffalo with a band from New Orleans, and Matt Booth is playing bass. So why don't I ask Matt if he can come and join us tonight?
Yeah,
so he flew up from New Orleans. We both played this afternoon in one of the most unlikely, what we musicians call doubles, where you play two gigs in one day. One of the most unlikely doubles we'll ever do is one in Buffalo and one in Rochester. And we could do a midnight gig in Syracuse, I suppose, if we really.
We gotta get moving.
So, yeah, speaking of getting moving, you know, we have a bunch of surprises, but then we realize we're only playing for about an hour, so why keep anything a surprise? So we're going to start by doing our next tune will be a song by Matt that we've never played before in the spirit of true jazz and improvisation. We're not even sure how it goes. So, and here it comes.
It's called Great Danes.
It's called Great Danes. Thank you.
Thank you. So many places I want to go with you guys tonight. Let's do this.
Oh, yeah.
You want to start it?
Okay.
It's another one I've never played before.
But all right.
I'll be fine.
Thank you.
Thank you.
with Matt Booth Trio. All right, so did anybody know the name of that song?
Fine.
Ah, yeah, you got it. It's considered the least popular Beatles song of all times. And the one song that was written by all four Beatles. It's true.
Well, are we going to try to keep this to an hour, guys?
Jen?
If you must.
If you must.
Well, I want to do this as a tribute to, the song I wrote is a tribute to Sonny Rollins.
Yeah.
In honor of his 91st birthday, it was just last week, and in honor of my good friend Jeff, who tried valiantly to rename the Williamsburg Bridge the Sonny Rollins Bridge in his lifetime. Someday it will. Yeah, he's still trying.
Still trying.
And thank you for that, because it's worthy. So this is a meditation for Sonny Rollins. It's called Sunny Days. Wow, thank you so very, very, very much. You listen to Harvey Sorgen on the drums. Matt Booth on the bass. Myself, Erik Lawrence. We traveled a long, long way, and this is dedicated to Jann and her birthday.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Bop Shop Records, Sonny Rollins, New Orleans. May it always survive everything that it goes through. And to all of you, so thank you. Is that good? Cupcake time?
Squeeze one more song.
Squeeze one more song in there, okay.
Because we love you, dear Jan.